of separationism is bound to inflame the passions of people, wouldn't you imagine?
The deeds that the white man has committed against black people is what is inflaming black people. There's no teaching inflames anyone. It's what you do to a man that inflames him. And if the white man wants black people to love him, then he should do something to warrant that love.
The entire Negro population, the group, feels the way you do about it. I think they're probably more than willing to live, take their share of the world that's available to them, and enjoy themselves in it.
How about you?
I have no comment on this topic.
If he doesn't think that very many Negroes think like I do, then he is being mighty naive. Do you think that Negroes are going to continue to live in a society where dogs can be sicked on them at will and not do something about it? You're out of your mind.
Is there anyone here that would like to comment after having heard what Mr. X said?
No, I don't.
How about you, sir? Would you like to comment?
I don't agree with him because I'm not a follower of Muhammad myself. I think that all people have been mistreated in some form or another. But I don't agree with him. I don't follow Muhammad. I don't think anyone should follow one man. I think they should follow their own conscience. I think the main problem of most Negroes is that they feel sorry for themselves. And I think that this keeps them back much more than they would be if they didn't feel so sorry for themselves.
If Martin Luther King, Roy Wilkins, or any of these compromising Negroes who say exactly what the white man wants to hear is interviewed anywhere in the country, you don't get anybody to offset what they say. But whenever a black man stands up and says something that white people don't like, then the first thing that white man does is run around to try and find somebody to say something to offset what has just been said. This is natural.